What can you do to prevent Malzahar from roaming right now?
Pushing.
Pushing. Exactly. Mm-hmm. In fact, you never want to roam like this if you don't create pressure. Because you, if you push this wave into the tower, you create pressure and Malzahar is going to be here. He can't move. If he wants to move, no problem. He's going to lose the wave. Hey guys, for those who don't know, my name is Bizyze and I'm a Challanger League of Legends coach. I have over 2,000 of hours on individual coaching and I have plenty of students that climb from bronze or silver all the way up to diamond. Remember that the content that you are watching right now is a personalized, high quality coaching session that you can only get from me. If you want to get better and climb in League of Legends, feel free to add me on Discord and book your own private coaching session. What are you waiting for? The link is in the description. We go for this game then 100%.
Okay. Yes. And another question, would you like to like maybe 2x review some game which I really hard lost lane, for example, after this one?
After this one? Today? So today we're going to do only 1 hour because I have another guy scheduled, but I want to go step by step because I can do 2 hours, 3 hours, I can do more, but it's not going to be efficient. If we just do session, and you don't have time to practice, it might be too much information for you. You're not really going to learn anything because I need to give you things to work on, you practice. Give you things to work on, you practice. If I just overload you with information, it's not going to work too well.
Okay.
So that's basically my
approach. Let's do this, then if you have time, I can ask something more. Yeah, okay.
Sure, 100%. Okay, perfect. So in this game, so let's see. Do you remember last time what we talked about? Do you remember what were the biggest mistakes?
Yeah, last time was actually I was so out of practice. I was forgetting about my Zhonya, forgetting about my summoner spells. Like it was very, very bad.
Okay.
And you were like telling me I should choose always 100% things as like roaming randomly when my jungler does something stupid. I shouldn't help.
Good. Okay, so those things. Okay, anything else?
I think first, no.
Okay,
I don't remember anything.
Perfect. Okay, so how do you carry a game on Victor? What should you do? Like, what's the most important thing?
Farming,
true. So we need to farm, and why do we farm?
Actually, I'm starting to think about Victor can also help and get these takedowns to get her passive going. But, like, most reliable would be then farm.
Yes, farm. So, on the laning phase, what do you think about the Victor? Like, is he a good champion lane or is he very bad?
It's not very bad, but I think he can struggle against some other laners when they are good. I don't think it has so much. Yes, he can poke very, very good, but like for all in lanes, I think it is not so easy to survive.
Like into Fizz, into Zed, into those matchups?
Yes.
Okay, so usually Victor is pretty good in the lane phase. He has a pretty strong early game power because of his Q and because of how easy it is for you to hit the Q, and you have a shield as well. So he's actually pretty good in the lane phase overall. But what about this matchup against the Malzahar? What do you think? What's your short term plan? Very good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what do you need to look for when you play this matchup?
I'm trying to hit my E against his creatures and him together, so I get the best value out of it, so he cannot push more than, and like I don't want to get pushed.
True.
And I can poke him more reliably, and so I can farm easy if I poke him good.
We need to poke him, we need to go aggressive. What else? What can Malzahar do? Like, let's take a look at him. What does he have?
Malzahar has his shield.
How do you get that?
Auto attack is not enough, right?
Auto attack is enough. Anything is enough. Ability on an auto attack. So that's the most important thing against Malzahar. Mm-hmm. You need to break his passive. How do you do it? Well, you can do it with E or Q, but the thing is going to deny your damage. It's like Yasuo passive, right? Like if you hit him, yes, you get his passive, but you don't do damage. So you want to break his passive with an auto attack.
Mm-hmm.
And after you break that, you want to trade. Remember that the more you hit him, his passive is regenerating, but if you hit him, the shield goes on cooldown again, so he's never going to get the shield.
Mm-hmm.
So what you should do is that you should constantly poke him so he doesn't mm-hmm. get his shield again. So right now, the first mistake that I did is that you're pretty late in the laning phase. Like right now, you already should be here. But why?
Mm-hmm. Okay, I was actually checking if nobody's coming, but I didn't notice. I think it was already late.
Yes, so why should we be fast on lane phase? Why is it important?
To be able to level 2 first.
Exactly, like you want to be as fast as possible here so we can start hitting the minions. We hit the minions mm. because we want to get level 2. But why do we need level 2?
Because we can heavily trade and maybe push him out of lane and base him.
True, like if you push, you can go for very easy, you can get level 2 advantage, get your E, and then you have 2 abilities. In addition of that, if you have 2 abilities, you can just go hard on him. And then if you have, let's say, 6 minions, and he has like 3 minions, it's going to be very easy for you to trade because you have the minions advantage. Mm. So mm-hmm. big mistake here that you're not really staying in the lane phase and you're not paying attention to the wave. So let's see what you're going to do. You're hitting the minions. That's fine. That's fine. You lost it. That's good. Good. Yeah, Malzahar is not in the lane phase. No problem at all. Right now he comes here. Good. You woke up, you have level 2 advantage. Beautiful. Beautiful, you abused level 2 advantage. That's fine. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. Okay, so let's talk about this. So right now, how do you feel in this position? Option number A, gankable, killable, catchable. Option number B, safe.
I feel pretty safe because it's too early. I don't expect from Kane to just come after, I think, 2 camps. It is too early. I think he was not there, so I was very fast pushing it. That's why I thought I can push this one more lane and let it full reset.
Okay, so right here, when do you usually get ganked as a mid laner?
I think around 3:20, 3:15. 2:30.
So from 2:30, yes. Because if he does 3 camps into ganking you, at 2:30 you're going to get ganked. So what do you think about this? 2:26.
I think it is gankable, of course, but I feel Malzahar was very low and I think I could run away. I actually. True.
But what if he comes and then he makes you low HP? Because he can't kill you. You're right. But he can chunk you.
Yeah,
yes. Exactly. So the rule of thumb is like this. You have more angles on the mid lane. So this one is basically danger. This one is basically safe. And this one is basically neutral with the yellow. Neutral. You're not gankable or ungankable. So right now you stay on the danger zone. When you stay on a danger zone, you can get ganked anytime. And usually after 2 minutes and 30 seconds, you can get ganked. So what you should do is that you should go for a ward. When you should go for a ward, because the ward is going to prevent you from getting ganked, when should you go for a ward? You should go for a ward, best case scenario, after pushing. So you push this wave, and then right now, if you just go, like right here, I can see if you're a platinum player or if you're a gold player. What will a platinum player do? He will simply go right here, drop a ward right now. What a gold player will do, he's going to be like, oh, I need to kill this guy. And he's not going to go for a ward. So what you should do is that you should be like, hey, right now I'm going to go into his tower. He's low on a Pokemon, I want to win the laning phase, it's important. But if I die, I mean, it's not going to be worth. So what if I push this wave, I go for a ward, because of course if I go for a ward, Malzahar can't really just follow me because there is this wave into the tower, right? So the rule of thumb is that you should push first and then you should go for a ward. And if you're very greedy in this pocket, you don't want to play without a ward. Very, very important. Because right now, if this guy was smart, you can see that he's level 3 already. So if he was smart, he could have just sneaked this. Super, super important. Okay, let's see. Good poke. Good. Wave is coming into you. You go for a ward. Beautiful.
Because I was expecting actually from top lane. I thought he would come.
True. You didn't know that he started on bot lane?
I thought he started from bot, but I thought he gets from bot to top side
Yes, that's fine. That's good to process. I like it, Sergio. Okay, good. Right here, what I can do, like a little thing that high elo players do after I did my research on Victor, like they go for 2 points in E. They don't really go for W. W is pretty bad. Even when you play in a the Zed matchups or Fizz matchup or Talon matchup or Mini matchups, doubled is not really that good. So you should go Q level 1, then you should go E, and then you should go E, and then you should go doubled. So two points in E. Because right now, if you poke him, you're going to chunk him more. Of course, E gives you damage. Because let's think about this. Do you really use the W in the next 10 seconds?
I was just thinking for Kane, actually. It was not about Malzahar.
True, but right now, since the wave is pushing towards you and you stay here. So what did we talk about? The pockets. Danger pocket.
This is very safe now.
Very exact. Like, if he's going to gank you, well, I mean, it's fine. You can get the kill in tower. Okay, good. 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 Nice pressure. You're pretty aggressive. I like it. Good. So let's actually write it down a little bit. So we talked about warding first and being in lane faster. Super, super important. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. All right. Right now, what is your plan in the laning phase? So what's your best recall timing on this champ?
When I could get 1,300 gold, it would be amazing.
True.
Mostly I base when I don't have mana anymore. It is
okay, perfect. Do you really need to base right now or can you stay more?
I think I will need to base soon because my mana doesn't look good.
Okay, so let's see what you're going to do first and then we can discuss about this. Okay, so you stay in the lane phase. So it's actually good that you stay. So your mana is, you have 150 mana, but the thing is you have a biscuit. The biscuit is also going to give you mana, 10% of mana. So if you have biscuit, you can stay here. If you have really, really, really low mana, you should obviously push the wave fast and go recall. But right now, it's not the case. You can just stay on the lane. Like, it's not an RGC to recall right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. So let's see what you're going to do. I like that you're trying to poke. Try to avoid for as much as possible to use your E on the minions. Because if you use the E on the minions and I'm Malzahar, I'm like, hey, this guy doesn't have VZ. Okay, I can just farm. I can just get the minions. He can't replenish me. Because he's on cooldown. So you need to avoid for as much as possible to use abilities on the minion wave. So here, let's see. Let's see what I did. So you try to use the E on the minions. Let's see.
I just did it because it's creatures, I think. Look, three creatures and I don't want him push me.
Why?
Because I think he need to use more mana and these creatures are pushing so much.
True, but you can also auto-attack them. You don't need to, because you see that you don't really have mana here, and you're just using your E, which is basically 80 mana. So you can just auto-attack the creatures. It's going to take like 3 seconds, and you don't really need to E here.
Mm-hmm.
You should avoid using the E like that, because right now you have no... You see the Malzahar? Like, right now he's confident. Look at him. Like, he was playing all the lane phase here, and right now he's like, hey, this Victor does heavy. Okay, I can just walk up and I can get the minions. So be careful with the... Because you're... With the your ability of using E on the minions, because you're wasting your pressure. Okay, good. Exactly, you did good here. You auto attack the minions. Nice, you're trying to punish. Good. Let's talk about one more thing. Right now, let's see. So in this position, what do you think about this positioning? Are we gankable right now? Can Kane gank us?
Actually, I should be around top more because I have top vision and my jungler is top.
True. So we need to play better around vision. So pay attention to your words. Right now, if you stay on this pocket, on the left pocket, you stay right here, mm-hmm. even if you poke him, there is very low chances that the gain is going to go like this because you have this ward. But if you stay here, or if you stay here, or if you stay here, and then he comes from behind, he's not going to kill you, true, but he's going to chunk you, which is still not good. Okay. Because you see your positioning right here.
We stay another side. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so we need to play around vision. Very, very, very important. Another concept. Okay, good. Good. Very good. You're poking him. Overall, you played the laning phase quite good. Quite good. I like it. Very, very, very good. Let's see what you're going to do right here.
I couldn't push. That's why I need to stay no more.
Okay, so you want to right there. Let's talk about it again. So right now you're poking him. You know that he's recalled because you saw him. You're like, hey, he's recalled. I need to push. And then after I push, of course, I need to crush this wave into the tower. And I want to make sure he loses the minions. And then I recall. That's what you did. Mm-hmm. It's just good. I don't like that you didn't reuse your biscuits to push faster. But overall, I like this. And right now you're pushing and you're like, hey, I didn't really push it in time. I had to push more faster. Yeah. So this way it goes into the tower. This is your mistake because you didn't really use the biscuit. But here you're like, hey, I need to stay to get this wave into the tower. This is good. This is good. Remember that if you're low HP, you don't want to do that because you're going to die for it. But right now you can do it. So you did it and you just recall. So this is correct. This is correct. Very good. And then you get the items. You are pretty fast. And then you go mid lane. Perfect. Perfect, 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 perfect. Good. Poking him. Good. Good. Very, very good. Very good W. Very good play. Right now Pikes comes in. Good wave management as well. Good poking. You keep the lane here. The more you keep the wave close to your tower, the better it is for you. So this is very, very good. Very, very, very good. Very good punishment. Good. Good. Pushing, pushing, pushing. Very good punishment. Right now we can see that you're also playing better. You're playing on the left angle. You should play like right here. It's better to play like this. But I appreciate that you're playing here. He's very, very low.
He is like non-existent with his health. That's why I was very cocky, I think.
Yes, 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 yes. This is very, very good. This is very good. You go for a plate, and then let's see what you're going to do. Okay, so let's talk about this. Let's talk about this. Let's talk about this. Okay, we go back. We go back. We go back. We go back. Okay. Played good. So far, so good. So far, so good. But let's see this play. So he's low. What does he want to do? He didn't stay in the lane.
Yes, yes.
He wants to base. Good. So if he wants to base, what do?
Stop it, if I can.
True. Okay. Push. True. So you try to stop it. You stopped him one time. But where is he right now?
I think he's behind tower trying to base.
True. So he's trying to base. So right now he's around base. So you should push the wave so you can crush this wave into the tower, right?
Mm-hmm.
What? Okay. Right now he's coming. He's coming and he's coming fast. And he also has items. So you're pushing, 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 pushing. Okay, right now, what happens if you stay here for 10 seconds, you get the plate, but then Malzahar is going to go in the lane phase. So what do you want to do after you get the plate?
Yeah, actually, I did it on purpose because I thought he couldn't farm. Like, I don't think he could have bought something meaningful that will mean disadvantage. So I thought I can just continue to lane because I have fast, nearly full mana and my jungler is behind me. I have vision. I was actually feeling pretty safe and I didn't want to base. I didn't have enough gold, I think, to buy anything.
So what happens if you go for a plate and he comes in the lane phase? What do you want to do after getting the plate here?
I think I didn't want to base because I was like, I had enough resources to stay.
True. So you have enough resources to stay to get the plate. But do you want to stay for more or do you want to recall after the plate?
Actually, I could recall, but I felt actually I can just continue to stay. I didn't want to recall now.
So here you go for the plate, okay. Let's say you get the plate, what do you do after?
Actually, if I based fast and took my item, it would be not bad to be stronger in lane.
True. So in fact, you should never go for those kind of plates. There are only two rules where Challenger go for plates. Because the thing is, right now, if you go for a plate, so right now we go for a plate, you got the plate, sure, you got the plate, but right now, if you think about this, did you use the gold for a plate? Did you spend your gold in the base?
No.
And then right now what happens is that, yes, you get an advantage. Yes, you push the plate, but let's see how much gold you're using. So you have basically 3k gold, okay? And you're not using 1.2k gold. So this means you're using 1.8k gold. So this is you. This is Victor. Malzahar that lost his laning phase and he's so behind, he has 2.3k gold, but he's not using 300. So how much gold do you have compared to him?
He's stronger than you.
Mm-hmm. But he's so bad and you beat him in the lane phase. But it doesn't matter because you stay for the plate. And right now, if you want to recall, what is he going to do? He's going to take your place as well. So because you overextended for the plate, he stays in lane phase and you have a lot of gold. And right now, you're stuck in lane. Because if you want to spend your gold, you need to go recall. And obviously, he's going to take three plates. So we're going to fix this mistake very, very easy with two rules that Challenger use. So you only need to go for the plates if two conditions, only two conditions. This is used by challenger players. If the plate is really, really low and you can just one-shot it. So, for example, if the plate is this HP and you take it, you run, instantly you recall. That's first condition. Or if after pushing the wave in, the enemy laner is still dead. So, for example, right now, first condition is not here, so the plate is not low. Second condition, so after you push the wave, right now, as we can see, the laner is not dead. So is it good to go for a plate?
No.
Not really. Not really. And then the biggest mistake here that you're doing, and let's say it's also like a huge thing that is going to give you elo, is that when challenger players play, they never go for plate and wave. It's way too greedy. It's way too greedy. They either stay for the wave and recall, or stay for the plate and recall instantly. They never stay for both of them. Only one. They are not greedy. Because here you're staying. And let's see what happens. Because, exactly, Kenny is going to come, and if Malazahar is very, very smart, he's just going to ult you. Exactly. Imagine if Kane was here. Good play. You played it a lot better mechanically than him, but look how much gold we have right now. And he didn't really spend it. If he was a good player with Kane, he could have definitely go on you. One second, because this is pretty bugged. Okay, 1 second so I can restart this one. Super important. You only go for a plate if the plate is low or if the enemy is still dead when you're taking the plate. Don't want to overextend for the plate because this is always going to happen and you're going to lose a lot of games if you... Because you won the laning phase, but it doesn't really matter. If you win the laning phase and then you don't recall, you don't use your advantage, it's not going to matter. Okay, let's see. Okay, so let's see. So you got one kill, you went in base. Okay, let's talk about this because I don't think we were here. Today we're going to talk about laning phase. And after I make this clean, I'm going to teach you something else, Sergeant. Okay, good. So let's see. Right now you get a kill on him. Good. So I think, so were we here or were we? Oh, yes. When you stay for the plate. Yes. This is bad. Okay, good. You stay, you kill him. Good. No problem. And then you recall immediately. Okay, so right now you had around 800 gold. Let's see. So let's actually see right here how much you had exactly. Okay, 1.7k gold. What are the options that you can buy on this champion, on Victor?
I could get shoes.
True. Or?
Go for my Ludens.
Go for your Ludens, true. Right now, this one gives you 40 AP. The boots, though, they give you penetration. So which is better? And movement speed.
If I respected my enemy more, I could go boots. But yes. I think I was, like, thinking he was pretty bad.
True, but the thing is, the boots are going to help you with the damage more. Because the boots gives you penetration. So it's better to have 40 AP plus penetration compared to have a little bit more AP, 70 AP, plus zero penetration. So it's so much better to get the boots here. In fact, every time when you have the blasting wand or the boots, you always go for the boots. Always. Because they give you penetration and you're going to do a lot of damage. Plus the movement speed. So here we should have just gone for the boots.
Okay.
Very, very, very important.
Some games, actually, many games I took not penetration boots, but these...
Cooldown reduction boots?
Cooldown reduction boots. Many games I did like that, but...
Do you ever go for Liandry's?
Liandry's? No.
This item. Liandry's Anguish.
No, I didn't go for it.
Okay, you see. Okay, good. Because you have some games when you're going for it. Usually, it's like this. When you play with Liandry's, you want to play with those boots. When you play with the Ludens, you can play with cooldown reduction boots. But in 99% of the cases, the Sorcerer boots are better. Because the cooldown reduction are fine. It gives you cooldown. Sure, you can just spam your Q. But you need penetration to actually kill the enemies. Because Victor, he doesn't really buy Void that early. Void stuff. Mm-hmm. So you should always go for Sorc boots. Always. Mm-hmm. Okay. Good, 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 good. Good, 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 good.
By the way, I didn't get any gold from this.
From from what? From the Drake?
Yeah, from this he opened in my lane this monster. What is it?
Oh yeah. I think
I need to auto attack the tower one to get gold.
This one?
No. If you continue, he opens my jungler opens the herald in my lane. For the plate.
Okay. Yeah.
And I get no gold from it, even though I thought it would be enough to be near it.
Good. So you poke him. Good. You poke him. Let's go step by step. You stay in the laning phase. What is Malazar right now?
I think he's trying to base again.
True. He's trying to base because he was low. So you try to actually push. So here, if you want to get the gold, you should stay around. Let's see. Wait, he didn't actually get the gold here?
No.
Holy shit.
That's why actually I wasn't going away just to take the gold, not to poke or anything.
Yeah, you should like stay here. But it's fine. There was the gameplay quality and it scared you, so no problem. I'm not concerned with this one. I'm concerned with what happens after. So right now, let's see. What is our team doing?
Drake.
True. They're doing Drake. Let's see the situation. Right now, what do you think about your HP first of all? Are you healthy enough to really go there and help them?
I didn't. I think I was pretty sure that he's not waiting me in the river. I was like thinking he's like around this where he is, or like somewhere maybe a little near to me. But I wasn't thinking that he's on the brush somewhere because my team was doing it and I saw Kane like in front of tower.
So what because if you rotate here? Okay.
He was my only worry because I know Malzahar must be so much behind. He's not there.
Okay, sure. So what if Kane flashes on you right now?
Yeah, I think he would go for Drake. I didn't think thinking about me at all. I think he wants to the dragon.
So what if Malzahar has boots and he is here right now? Because that could happen. So what can you do? What can you do to prevent Malazahar from roaming right now?
Pushing.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. In fact, you never want to roam like this if you don't create pressure. Because if you push this wave into the tower, you create pressure, and Malazahar is going to be here. He can't move. If he wants to move, no problem. He's going to lose the wave. So right here, you're too low to really follow the Drake, first of all, and you should always push your wave, clear your wave before following. So the rule that you should use is that you always push the wave before roaming, unless the fight is very, very, very close to you. So for example, if you're staying here and you have a Kane right here and he's very, very free kill, you go and you take the free kill. You don't care about the wave. But in 99% of the cases, pushing and rotating after pushing is better, because you force Malzahar to take the wave.
I actually really wanted to have my passive, like I thought Kane will definitely go in and die for Drake still, and I just wanted to have my assist at least so my passive goes faster. It was, I think, what I thought.
True, but remember that we talked about 50-50 plays. If you push the mid lane, it's 100% guaranteed. If you go for the assist, maybe you get it, maybe he doesn't go right now, maybe it's a maybe, right? So that's why you should go for the more reliable play and always push the wave here.
Okay.
Very, very important. Okay. Good. 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 Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. You get Ludens Echo. That's beautiful. You're very, very, very strong. Try to be very, very careful when you're playing against Malzahar and you don't know where is the jungle. Because right now, you're taking the vision and the enemy jungle could be around. Like, this guy is very, very, very bad with Malzahar and he could have just stayed here, ulti you, and you're dead. So the rule of thumb that you should use is that when you play against a champion that can set up the gank very well, like Malazahar, Malphite, like those really crazy, crazy good engage champs, you want to play safe. You want to play safe, farm, and then after you push, you go long way. You don't really want to like face check like this. They were, this Malazahar is probably autofill. He's really, really bad. He doesn't punish you. So, but you need to be very careful here. So when you're going for those wards, remember, he could have just gone on you. This guy was very, very slow. And he didn't. Also, the Kane missed everything. Be careful when you're playing against Malazahar like that. Okay, good, 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 good. Okay, so let's see some macro decisions, some team fights from you. Let's see. So how much gold do you have here? So 1.6k gold. Good. You need to recall very soon. So here, what do you think about this?
I think it was greedy. Yeah,
very, very like, greedy.
Why I'm here.
Very, very greedy. Yeah. Every time when you have more than 1k gold, it's very greedy. So the rule of thumb is when you have 1k gold or more, highly prioritize to push and recall. You have a lot of gold, they can kill you, Malazahar can go on you as well, and you're never going to get the tower as well. Like, it's going to be very, very difficult for you to get the tower. Wow, this is very, very greedy. The thing is, you're playing in, if you play in gold 4 like this or silver 1, you're going to win so much until gold 2. But in gold 2, you're going to drop to gold 4 again with this playstyle. Very, very important. Every time when you have a lot of gold, recall.
Yes, it is. Now I see it is not very best, but I thought Malzahar is so bad that I could under tower, like, let him go base, but it was very greedy, I see.
Exactly, because this guy is bad, I agree with you, but he can, if Kane comes, he presses R on you and you're dead. Exactly, so it's not really about necessarily about the player, but it's about what if you get Kane, what if he has ultimate, and he has ultimate with Malzahar. Super, super important. Okay, so right here, let's see. I want you to tell me the mistake here. Let's see. So we talked about that today. Let's see. So what should we do? Let's see. We go mid lane. Good. You clear the wave. Good. What should we do right now?
I think I should take another route. There can be Kane there waiting. Yeah.
True. True. What else? What about the mid wave?
First pushing.
Exactly. You see,
but I think it is like it was... Fire Drake, and I thought it is more important to be with my team.
The thing is, if you push the wave and Malazahar is right here, and then you follow, it's 4 versus 5, which means it's free win. Free win. If you go and the wave is here, Malazahar is going to be in the team fight. 5v5 is not that free win. And you see how close the game is? It's actually not that... of course, the gold is pretty big. So push first, and then we just want to follow. Because you see that even if you're here right now, it doesn't really matter. Like, what if you're here and you push? Right now, the wave is pushed in and then you just follow.
Yeah.
Exactly, exactly. So, big thing, big thing. So, we talked about today also wave management. Okay. Okay, good, 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 good. Very good positioning. I think that last time your positioning was very good as well, because I remember that.
Okay.
Good. Recall, don't stay in the laney phase. So what's your normal build on the Victor?
I go Ludens, and then mostly, even though you told me second Zhonya's, I think many games I'm going second Rabadon on third Zhonya's if I need more damage.
True. Another combination would be, did you ever try this item? The Cosmic? Is it actually pretty OP?
No.
You should try it. It's definitely pretty good. Oh, what did you say? Sorry?
Is it the second item or third item? How?
Second item.
Mm-hmm.
So
but
usually...
it keeps...
Yeah, go on.
Gives you, when you have more AP, it is more efficient. I thought like this.
True,
it is,
but this item also gives you movement speed, and it gives you very good stats. 20 ability haste, 200 health. The health is so important. And then 80 ability power. So what high low players do, usually, they go Ludens, and then they're like, hey, am I very, 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 very ahead? And if they are very ahead, they go Death Cup, and then they go Cosmic. This is basically their build. But if they are not very, very ahead, let's say they are, you know, 0-0 or 1-0, not very ahead, then they go for Cosmic because this is a cheaper item, and then they get Death Cap.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends. Right now, what do you think? 3-0.
Actually, that's why I think I'm ahead.
Yes, Death Cap is good. Death Cap is good, but your boots are not good. You should go Sword Boots.
Yes.
Perfect, you're staying mid lane, you're taking blue buff. Your rotations on the map are fine. Good, good. I want to see some of the team fights that you actually played in this game. Good, good. Last time, did you have time to watch the... So what homework did I give you last time?
I think homework was like playing 17
the
games.
Did you have time to do the session one more time as well? Or not?
Really? I watched like the half of it one more time, not the whole, but I watched
good.
Like
because I can see I can see a lot of good things, by the way, a lot of good things in this thingy. Okay, I like a lot of good things, a lot of positive things that you got better. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Recall, good. Death Cap, you're a strong boy. I want to see how you play team fight right now. 200 farm right now, very good. Very good. You go mid lane, beautiful play, beautiful. Your map presence is very good. Your poking is good. Do you know how many games exactly you played on this champ? Right now, like last couple days.
I think it must be more than 25.
More than 25. Okay, good because I can see big improvements in terms of mechanics. Okay, tell me, what is your job in team fights?
My job is to, I think, land a good W and like make as much damage as possible.
True. But in terms of team fighting, how should your positioning be usually?
I was like scared of like permalocked with Malzahar. It was like my only like thing because I thought I was very strong. Besides Malzahar R, I thought I cannot be killed.
True. So the Malzahar R is a very important thing that you need to avoid. You want to stay max range and remember, he could flash on you. So it's not just Malzahar R. Okay, yeah. What else? Because there are also other things. Like there is one thing.
Then W from Kane that he cannot.
True,
go.
But he's an assassin Kane, so he just has a slow. So he's not that big. Right, mm-hmm. And then also this guy has a slow, but it's not that big. If you stay at a very respectable distance, like this distance with them, and you just stay max range, you're fine. What about the Nami?
Nami bubble
and Nami R as well, because that's big range. So you want to stay behind of your team, and you want to respect Malzahar ulti, which means you want to stay out of his range, and you want to also respect the Nami. Because here, let's see what we do. Because you never want to stay front line with this champion. This is fine.
Yeah, this was my mistake. I think I was too excited when he,
he got caught here.
I think it was my mistake. I wanted to punish it, but it was like stupid why I'm doing it. Because I knew in the moment I put W, I said, what am I doing? He will just immediately E away. So it was actually... I knew it. It was bad in the moment I did it, actually, before it ended bad.
Exactly. In fact, right here, exactly in this position, if you're going to get hit by this bubble, then it means Kane is going to W, which means the Nami ulti is going to come. So what Faker will do here is going to be... So if you are in this moment right now, you know that you fucked up. So then you just do Zhonya's.
Yeah.
So you Zhonya's the bubble. When you get out of Zhonya's, you basically bait everyone, you bait them to go into you, and then you flash and kill everyone with ER. So what Challenger players do, they do this intentionally.
Oh, okay. They
do this intentionally. They try to act like they get caught, they Zhonya's, everyone goes on them, they Zhonya's, and then enemy team is here. And then they flash here, use EQR, because if enemy team is here, I mean, it's so big combo AoE, right? So here we should just use the stopwatch. Again, no problem. This is basically a mistake in terms of the team fights. We wanna move on. Okay. And be careful because if you want to be a Platinum 4 player, you're never going to get there if you do those kind of mistakes. Because for gold, for silver, I mean, it's fine, but I don't want to talk about silver with you because you said you want to get platinum, so you need to play better than this. Okay, good. Good, you stay with your team. This is good. This is good. This is good. This is good. Okay, that's fine, recall. You have a lot of gold. This is the one of the first times when you actually recall because you have some gold. But ping your teammates. Because right now they want to pressure. Because they have Nashor, right? But you have a lot of gold, so you just need to recall. But try to ping them. Danger, 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 danger. Guys, don't fight. If you fight right now, you die, you lose Nashor. I'm in base. I can't help you. Mm-hmm. So you should ping at least 2 times, but I recommend 3 times. Danger. Not 6 times because you don't want to get muted. But right now, if Pike is stupid, he's going to face check everything exactly. Exactly. Since I died, and this guy almost died as well. Exactly. You see this? Very, very important. Ping them. We got lucky that we have a Pike, but any other support would just die there. Beautiful play. You're level 17. You're very, very far. Wait, you lost this game, right?
Yes. It is impossible.
Wow, you lost this game. I want to see how you lose it, this actually.
This guy, this is like where things started.
Okay, so let's talk about this. Let's talk about this. Okay, you're chilling, you're staying with your team. Oh, sorry?
He one-shotted nearly with his...
with his auto and yes, that's good. You're running, that's fine. You missed a click here. So mechanical execution right now, you're using your E. So what do you think about this situation? Should we flash away or can we kill him?
Actually, if Jin didn't like got one-shotted, I thought it was easy 2v1, but he was just not there and I was 1-1. Now I have to fight with him.
True. So is this doable? Can you win this?
It
is, right? It is doable because you're very, very strong. You're very, very strong. You're strong. He's strong as well, but you're strong as well. So here, you shouldn't really use Zonias. But why?
I'm waiting my cooldowns now. Because if I don't use, I don't have cooldowns, I'm dead.
But the thing is, what happens if you use the Zonias and he gets the barrels on you and he kills you? So do you have any ways of buying time right here with your summoner spells? Instead of Zonias, because if you Zonias, you're untargetable. So he gets here with the barrels, you're dead.
Yeah, flash away and barrier, but exactly. Flash away and barrier maybe.
Yes. Because if you barrier here, if you barrier, you're going to have your ultimate up because you buy 1 more second. But 1 more second in this team fight, this means a lot, right? Because if you just try to start with the barrier and then you just try to use your ultimate, he's just dead. But you wasted so much time. And here. You see how important it was? Because you waited his cooldowns as well. So next time, do not use the Zonias. Prioritize using the barrier first. Because it's 435 damage from your champion's just temporary shields. So this is a lot. This is a lot. So here, and this is huge actually. Because we gave a shutdown to a gangplank that will carry. In addition of that, we lost our flesh. So next team fight, you can't play that aggressive because you don't have your flesh. So here you might have lost the game. This game is going to show you if you're a Plat player. So we will see. Because this game is not easy. Top inting, AD carry inting, blah, blah, blah. But if you're a Platinum player, easily carry this. A main Victor that is Platinum 4 will carry this. Not just a random Victor. Because you need to hit your spells very well, AoE. But let's see. Let's see what you're going to do. Okay, so we get Got right here.
Was very bad. My team was really not doing anything.
True, but where should we stay usually in the team fights?
I was trying to zone them from, from Drake. I wanted to like take control of the area.
Okay, but let's think about this. So, what did you say that you want to avoid getting hit by in the team fights?
Actually, at that point, I was like afraid only from Gangplank and Kane because Kane was constantly trying to catch me, and Malzahar was so far away, so he was not really.
So what if Malzahar flashes on you?
Yeah, then I'm
just dead. So is it more important to be safe or to zone and do damage?
Safe. Okay.
Exactly. Because this Malzahar is so bad. So look at this. So this is fine. Good positioning. You're staying behind of your team. But right now, flash ulti, Victor is dead, we win the game. We push mid, end the game. You see this Malazar? Yeah. He's probably like silver first time Malazar. Look at his clicks. Q. Look at this. Mm-hmm. He can even ult you without flash. You see this? He can walk up here, ult you. He's going to get chunked a lot because of Ree. But does it matter if you kill Victor and you die when you play Malazar 1-2 and you have a team that is good?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So you need to be more patient. Because you played good. But it doesn't matter if you're going to misstep in team fights. This guy was very bad. And he could have also flashed on you right here. Like if he walks up, he can also flash on you. Plus Kane can flash. Like here, Kane can flash on you, W, you're dead. He also got the W without flashing, you see? So this is a mispositioning team fight. If you had flash, it would have been a little bit different.
Mm.
Pretty hard fight. Your team is very stupid. But if you step up, if you carry completely, it doesn't matter if they are stupid. Because they are going to die, but then you just kill two people as well. And it's so much better.
Mm-hmm.
So much better. So if you are good, you can still carry them. Again, this is not an easy game. So this is not going to prove anything. Because this is not a normal gold game. This is the gold 1 platinum 4 promo, let's say.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good fight. Taking the blue. Good, you're very, very strong. Recalling, Banshees, Morello. That's fine.
Yeah, I took Banshees because I don't want to die, actually.
Against Malazar, right?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yeah, this was my... Actually, I tried, okay, maybe.
So what should we do? How do we play this?
I suicided to steal, I think. It was not like... Because I was pretty sure we are not winning any team fights anymore. Because, like, look at my Jin Zhao. He's, like, just completely disconnected from game. Like, doing what is he doing in bot side? So I thought if they take Baron, it's done. So I thought I steal it and suicide for it. So.
You should still be patient. So the question is, do we have a chance to 5 versus 5 or is it completely over?
I don't say it's completely over, maybe a little chance.
So yeah, you have a chance. If you play good with your flash, with your E, with your Q, you can do this champion does so much damage. So much damage with Victor. So it's so much better to not flip it, because here, maybe you get a Drake, but I mean, who's going to get an Usher here, right? So it's so much better to simply stay with your team, because what if you're staying here? Look at this fight. This is so bad, so good. You can't have something better than this. You let Pyke to go in, you stay here, you do so much damage, you kill Gangplank, because remember, you have Zhonya's and Flash. Gangplank doesn't have Zhonya's, he only has Flash. So if you stay behind of your team, you'll still have a chance. So in those kind of cases, be patient. No need to steal the Nashor or do anything crazy. Wait, yeah, they end like this? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's ending, I think, or not. Okay, so no, it's not ending, It's just like just... painful, it goes on and on. Yeah,
very, very hard game, very, very difficult game, but I could have win it. So we lost it, you know, when you lost it right here with the barrier. Yes, you had a lot of mistakes in terms of lane phase as well, but overall I really like how you played it overall. So I can see huge improvements from the last time. Of course, there are still a lot of things that we need to work on for platinum, but I'm very, very proud of your victory at the moment. Definitely. I can see nice improvements in terms of laning phase, in terms of aggressivity. Wave management, it's not clean, but it's getting there. So I really like this. Let me give you a homework right now. So today we talked about a lot of things. Talked about warding, talked about playing around vision. We talked about wave management and rotations. Next time, if you show me and if you prove to me that you improve on those things, I will show you other things, more complex. But you need to show me that you have, first of all, good laning, good wave management, and then we go for other things. Okay?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Perfect. About